Hello everyone, this is Ekta Takrani. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will continue with Civics Chapter 4, that is Working of Institutions. So, in the last video, I was telling you about the executives and we have discussed the types of executives. So, there are many people who are the part of the executives, like I told you, the President, the Prime Minister, the Council of Ministers. All these people together collectively form the executives. So here we are going to talk about the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers. So again, recall the point of the office memorandum. What was the role played by the Prime Minister? How the Council of Ministers given their approval and how they discussed the issue? Like this, the example was given to see how they work. Here we will be talking in detail about this group, how they are appointed, what are their powers and all. Okay, so let us begin with the Prime Minister. The first thing that the Prime Minister, there are no direct elections. If you want to be the Prime Minister, there will not be any direct election to be the Prime Minister. So how the Prime Minister is elected? The President. The President appoints the Prime Minister. Now, President cannot appoint anyone he likes that he will be the Prime Minister now. No, the ruling party, the majority party, from the majority party, the leader of the majority party, the one who gets maximum support in the majority party, we can say the leader, he is appointed as the Prime Minister by the President. Okay, the President is electing him. Though the Prime Minister will be more powerful in future, you will see. But here, the President appoints the Prime Minister. Okay, I hope you have got this much. After that, what is the tenure? There is again no fixed tenure as long as he enjoys the power in the majority party. The majority party, he is the leader of the majority party as long as he will remain in office. He will remain in power. So that is about the tenure and the elections. That much is clear. Okay. Once the Prime Minister is elected, what we have seen, he is the leader of the majority party, the Prime Minister is appointed, next there are no direct elections, then there is no fixed tenure, as long as he will enjoy the support, he will be the in power. Then, once the Prime Minister is appointed, the President appoints other ministers, okay, other Council of Ministers. The President is appointing, but now they will be working together. The President appoints other ministers on the advice of the Prime Minister. Means now these both will decide. Okay, both will together appoint the different ministers as they have to work as a team. So they will be selecting the different ministers. Who are these ministers? We usually use the term Council of Ministers. What is this council? Council means a group. Council of Ministers is the official term used for all these ministers together. It's the body of ministers. We are, you know, it's about 60 to 80 members. 60 to 80 ministers are forming the Council of Ministers. So these ministers are of different ranks. So all together we call them Council of Ministers. Okay, so they are different categories, different ranks as per their powers. Let us see who all are these three. The three categories are given here. The cabinet ministers, ministers of state having independent charge, and ministers of state. Now, who are these cabinet ministers? They are taken as the top level ministers. Top level ministers. Means they have more powers. Major decisions, major meetings are taking place in the cabinet. Top level ministers. Next is ministers of state with independent charge. They have got their particular charge and they are attending the cabinet meetings only when specially invited. They are invited and they are attending the cabinet meetings. Next is ministers of state. They are also part of this and what they are doing, they are assisting the top level ministers. They are assisting the cabinet minister and as they all are working together. So they are like the assistant. Next, now As I told you, 80 members are there in a vast country. So many things are there to discuss. So it is very difficult for them to come together and discuss always. So most of times meetings are taking place as cabinet meetings. Cabinet is deciding, discussing and taking the decisions. Okay, that is why you know in many countries this our type of government, form of government is also known as cabinet form of government. Yeah, playing a major role. They discuss, they debate, they come together to the conclusion. Here the ministers cannot criticize openly anything. They cannot criticize the government. They are all are working together, they discuss, and in these ministries, different departments they are having the secretary also. Now who is the secretary? If you remember, I told you in last video about permanent executive, the civil servants, the experts, the people experts in finance and trade and foreign exchange, everything. So these experts are the secretaries, are the civil servants, and even some of the senior civil servants are being the part of these ministries. They all are working together. These civil servants are assisting the cabinet ministers and they are working together to discuss and work for the welfare of the people. So this is how all these people function, the prime minister and the different council of ministers. There are many more things to tell about the prime minister, the powers and all, and about the president also. So the powers of the president and prime minister we'll be discussing in the next video. Till then, I have shared so many videos till now. So go through all the videos and prepare notes very well. Goodbye.